Now, the five-star movement has refused to recognise Juan Guaido as interim president. Now, given the hardship that Venezuelans are facing in daily life, how can you justify that?
Well, thank you, first of all. It's just the fact that we use a lot of realpolitik at the end. I mean, Guaido hasn't the control of the country. Maduro, if we like it or not, and we never say that we like it, is controlling the control, is controlling the forces. So what we need to do, first of all, is to avoid a civil war, is to avoid the new Iraq, a new Libya, a new Afghanistan.
So you agree with Maduro when he says that support for Juan Guaido could cause a civil war in the country?
Well, Maduro is part of this, in case. So obviously, when he says it with a lot of reality. I mean, we are looking at a situation where there is Maduro, Russia, China, and other countries together, and on the other side we have the United States and another coalition of countries willing to do whatever they can to achieve their own goal. So in this situation, if the first thing we have to do is to calm down the situation, and we're doing this to protect our Italians there. We have 150,000 Italians in Venezuela, so we need to think at the peace process, first of all, political process, and that's why we are so proud to have brought in Europe this group of contact that now is dealing with Maduro and with Guaido to go through new and democratic election. This is our goal. I mean, it's the same goal that Guaido has and the people that are asking to withdraw Maduro is asking. The point is how you achieve this goal. We think that to stress the situation, to have wall against wall, could create a very bad situation. So we want a political process. That's all at the end.
OK, well, Mr. Stefano, let's turn to European issues now. The relations between Italy and France have declined massively since your governments came into power. France recalled its ambassador from Rome. We hear now that ambassador is going to return. Are we seeing a resolution to these declining relations?
Well, let me first say that France is a twin country for us. I mean, we've been working and cooperating for decades. So this is not a problem with France. This was a problem with the Macron policies and the international policies and the Macron government. This is what we can say. We are very happy that the ambassador is coming back. We have plenty of things to work together on. But I think that as we ask to meet different parties in Europe to create a coalition for the next European election, nobody can say us that we are not allowed on doing it. And this was, at the end, the problem with Mr. Macron. I mean, we've been trying to create a cooperation with the good part, not the violent part, obviously, of the yellow vest, and he was upset with that. And I think that the reality is that we have been talking about Africa and the French neocolonialism, and this made him crazy, you know? So I think that if you want to save Europe, I was listening to you before talking about the populist parties and the nationalism and so on. And I think that if you want to protect Europe, you need to talk without hypocrisy of the root causes of the issues that we have, like migration. And when it comes to migration, you have to talk about the neocolonialism that France, for example, is having on 14 ex-colonies. You know, these are factual things. So if we want to have a good policy, European policy, you have to start from fighting these root causes.